So recently I've heard a lot of people whinge about how much the Tesla Model 3 is in the UK and how much new cars cost in electric. But what no one ever goes into is how cheap used electric cars are. So today we're going to be exploring how you can get a used electric car for under £8,000. Yes, under 8K you can buy a used electric car. Have you ever
felt? Are you listening? Damn.
However, in the UK, we don't have a website like MyEV in America, so we have to use the old traditional website for searching for cars, which is Autotrader. And Autotrader wasn't built for searching for EVs, so to narrow it down to the ones that we can afford, we need to do a couple of things. Firstly, head over to Autotrader's website. When you get there, you need to click on the advanced options. When you've gotten to the advanced options, we need to then select electric car. And because this video is about cars that are under 8K, we need to change the price settings to under £8,000. Now, because of the extremely irritating way Autotrader is designed, their sponsored adverts come up first. So if you're trying to find an electric car for under £8,000, you'll find all their sponsored adverts first, and we don't want that. We want to find the cheapest possible EV for under £8,000. So you need to change their price distinction to from low to high. And if you're not bothered about how far you travel, you can change the search to national. If you only want to travel within a certain range of what the EV does, then change the range on what you're willing to do on your first journey. But I'll tell you now, the first time you do a long journey in an EV, your worry of range anxiety just disappears. You go, this was easy. But if you want to buy one locally, change the nationality of how far you want to go from national to 50, 60, 70, 80 miles, whatever you're willing to go up to. Now you'll notice you're still currently seeing Renault Twizys and iMEVs, and we want to see proper EVs. We want to see stuff like the Renault Zoe. We want to see stuff like the Nissan Leaf. And to do that, we need to change the seat option to 5 seats. And that's because stuff like the Renault Zoe and the Nissan Leaf have 5 proper seats. The only EV in this list that wouldn't have 5 proper seats that's a proper EV is the BMW i3. There's a video of how I won a BMW i3 on the top right hand corner of this video, but the i3 wouldn't become under £8,000, so we're not going to talk about it in this video today. But proper EVs all have 5 seats like this and the Nissan Leaf, and that's why if we select 5 seats, we're just going to filter those out. Now there's an important thing to know about Nissan Leafs and Renault Zoes that fall under £8,000. And that is, most of them are battery lease. Now, battery lease is a monthly payment to RCI that pays for the battery. So you're buying the car, but the battery is owned by Nissan or Renault. And the reason that I actually approve of this is on an old car, an older electric car, the biggest worry, the biggest thing I always heard people whinge about is, it'll be all right until the batteries go wrong. Well, if the batteries go wrong, they're leased, not your problem. So you get a free battery replacement and all the labor paid to replace that battery. So simple solution. Now, some Nissan Leafs have battery owned under this £8,000. And if a Nissan Leaf has a battery lease, you can buy it out. So that's a very, very important thing to know. A Nissan Leaf, you can buy the battery lease out. Now, currently on the Renault Zoe, you cannot buy the battery lease out yet. I'm not hinting at anything, but rumour mills say that one day it will happen. And in the past, I said completely do not buy a Zoe if you ever think you're going to buy the lease out. And that still applies. If you buying a Renault Zoe today and think that one day you'll be able to buy the lease out, don't do it. Because if it never happens, you'll blame me. And I'm just saying at the moment, it's not possible. But it might do in the future. Maybe. Don't trust my word for it. I'm just taking a guess, an educated guess, on what I've seen happen in the rest of Europe on some Renault Zoes, where I've been informed. Guy in the comments, if you ever want to comment, by the way, comment down my videos down below. Don't forget, by the way, you can click subscribe while you're down there. And if you click the notification bell, there's a video next week on how to buy a used electric car, the quirks, the problems, the faults that you need to look out for on buying a used electric car. And if you click that notification bell after you click subscribed, you will be notified when that video goes live. Sorry, I was digressing there. Back into battery lease. So they are leased batteries. The responsibility of that battery stays with Renault or Nissan while it's leased. And if the battery drops below a certain state of health, you'll get a brand new battery. Now, this should work out for most people, depending on your mileage. The battery lease payment per month should be less than your fuel, tax, and servicing costs. And then the price it costs to charge an electric car, as most of us know, is pretty much peanuts. But if you do want to work out how much an electric car would cost you to charge at home, easiest way of doing it, go and get your electricity bill, find out what you're paying per kilowatt hour of electricity. And most Nissan Leafs, Renault Zoes, are about a 22 kilowatt battery. So if we add some losses in there, let's call it 28 kilowatts. So if you times 28 kilowatts by the price you pay for electricity on your electricity bill, that will give you roughly how much it costs to charge your car from zero to full. And that's how much it'll cost you to do between 60 and 100 miles, depending on how economical you drive and how flat it is where you live. Thank you very much for watching this week's video. Thank you very much to my patrons that have supported my channel for months and months on end. They are the reason why my videos carry on going. I make tremendous losses running this channel on buying equipment, audio equipment, wireless mics like I have on today, and also paying for Premiere Pro. The losses are so big that I would have stopped doing the channel ages ago if it wasn't for my patrons helping support my channel and giving me confidence that the channel's growing and it's getting bigger. So thank you very much for them. If you do want to become a Patreon, please go and click the Patreon link up here. But don't forget to subscribe and check out my other videos. Thank you very much, and I'll see you again next week, where I'm going to show you what you need to look out for when you're buying a used electric car.